Now, they have come to make communication on social media seamless. Whether we mean them or not, emojis have come to stay. Today is World Emoji Day, and we have been finding out what impact these small characters have had on our everyday interactions.
Today, we celebrate tiny characters that have made communication so much better, but also a little bit more complicated. And I'm talking about emojis. Standing next to me is Komla Adom with his black and yellow tie, looking like an emoji himself.
Hi, Maps. You know, these emojis, just as you said, even though they've made life simple for us now, they can be complicated sometimes. So in the past, I could say, I love you, but it was hard for me to say it to you. But now I can use an emoji to say, I love you.
So how would you tell me that you love me with an emoji?
Maybe I do the... my eyes, yeah.
I think this is how I would respond, with like a really like lovely smile, like a...
Yes, but that is not all. Uh-huh. There are some of the emojis that we use to communicate our disgust for maybe a silly comment or something a friend would have posted on social media. So I may do something like, yeah. Yeah, and maybe something like, oh gosh, that could have been better.
Or like, what?
Like, yeah. Did you really say that?
Did you really say that?
Yeah.
But another thing about emojis is that both of us are from different countries. Mm-hmm. And emoji to me, what meaning for emoji to me means a different meaning to you. So how do we work around that? So for example, a peach to me might mean a completely different thing to you.
Yes, the peach.
Let's talk about the peach and the eggplant. In the car when we're coming, I asked you if you knew what a peach meant, and you didn't know.
Yeah, but now I know, Maps.
And would you like to share with our viewers?
We'll show them.
We'll show them. Okay, so go. Obviously, you guys have a phone. So you go to your WhatsApp, and then you type peach.
Okay.
So you go to peach, and if you're using an iPhone, it will show you a peach. Mm-hmm. And just look at the peach very carefully. And if you know, you know.
Right. I know now, Maps.
Yeah.
Yes, I know.
All right.
And the eggplant.
And the eggplant.
You have the peach, I have the eggplant.
If you know, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so now we're going to find out from various people what they take from emojis.
Yes, and how exactly you're able to use the emojis to communicate their emotions to one another.
If I want to express my feelings, I sometimes go to the emoji page and then I take what I need from it. So, and some people don't want to talk a lot, so you just go there and then use whatever they want to use. I think it has made it easier in some aspects, and it has complicated it as well, because sometimes you send an emoji to someone and they don't even understand what you're sending to them. They sometimes misinterpret what you are trying to mean, and then it can get all fuzzy, and I mean, people quarrel because of emojis, so I think it has rather complicated things.
To an extent, sometimes you want to convey your thoughts and your feelings through words, but I think one of the ways to miscommunicate greatly is to text. And the emojis helps in a way bridge the gap by communicating your feelings that you cannot express through words.
Emojis have been very vital in our community these days, especially when mostly using WhatsApp. It helps in communication, as in sometimes you just don't feel like typing. Just sending an emoji will just tell what you want the person to know. Yes, and it has been very vital in our society. And it's using emojis, when I'm using emoji, I really mean it. Maybe I just can't type, maybe for example, I love you. I just send the emoji of love, and then it tells everything.
So Maps, you heard the people there. I mean, the emojis have made life easy for all of us.
Okay.
But in the past, when I want to hug somebody or hug you, for example, like, when I do not know you, I don't have that relationship with you, it will be difficult for me to do that. But with the emojis, I can simply send a hug emoji.
And I think also for the guys, it's easier for you to just hit on a girl, to be like, you know what, send you a heart face, or, you know, to be like, hey girl, wink.
Pinkies in your eyes.
Yeah, and it's just so much easier for girls and guys to get along with each other, you know. What's your favorite emoji?
My favorite emoji, the one with the kiss, the love on the cheek.
So my favorite one, I'd say, you see the smiley face with the teardrop, like a...
You're blushing, are you not?
Yeah, I'm blushing, but I've got like a teardrop or something. Is it a sweat or a teardrop? I don't even understand.
Well, that would mean, you have so much to deal with.
But I'm smiling.
But I think.
You see, misunderstood.
That's true. Mab, so I think we've heard from all of them. I mean, emojis are great, but sometimes they may misrepresent exactly what you feel or you want to communicate.
And I think that's why it's important for you to know the person you're talking to, so that you have some sort of connection and energy you guys share, so that you know that if I'm sending you a heart, it's not because I love you or I want to have sex with you or I want to date you. It's because, you know, we have that connection. We are buddies. I don't want to get in bed with you.
Absolutely. And remember, you do not want to use emojis for official or formal purposes. I mean, you cannot send an emoji to your boss, for example. Or is it acceptable?
I think it depends, like I said, the type of connection that you have with your boss.
I can't send an emoji to my boss.
Boss, can I send an emoji to you?
Well, so from myself, Komla Adom.
And me, Mapito Sividi.
We say have a wonderful Emojis Day.
And keep on emojis.